communication is how I then try and convey a message, which might be verbal, also might be using one of these. So they're what we would call the brilliant basics. Yeah. So if you're watching from the sideline, maybe choose one of those and have a look at what I try and do to display those things. I'm going to look at the skills corridor in a minute. You're going to go into player mode. I want you to think about opportunities to stay on the ball and master the ball, get better. But also opportunities in the next 10, 15 minutes to excite with the ball and try and seek some creative solutions. Yeah? Try and really impress me, but also impress yourself. 12 players, who's in? If you're in this line, you're going to peel round to the left. If you're in that line, what do you think you're going to do?
I think further out.
Peel round to the right. What about if you're in this line?
You
have a decision to make, go left or right, but don't keep going. Yeah? Turn left or right. Ready? Play! Second one to go. Fourth one to go. I see you get used to the ball. Really enjoy it. Go three times round, keep going.
Three times?
Yeah. Patrick! Nice, who's using both feet? Hello, we've got cheeky step overs in there. Players is, do we always play football in straight lines? No. So this time, think about cutting across, zigzags. It might involve using different parts of the feet. A little tip I might throw into young players would be, every time you touch the ball, what should they do with their head? Look up, yeah? Try and do it twice every time you touch the ball. So you're always looking up, but we're zigzagging across. When you get to the end, you can choose. Ready, play! Go on, go when you're ready, go when you think you should. Nice. That's it, really cut into it. Good tempo, I like it. When you go through the skills corridor, sometimes I'll say to the kids, it's skills with a Z, not an S. So I'm down with the kids, it's a better way to spell it, so I'm told. Good job, I'm not an English teacher. In here, now you can do whatever you like, but if it's the skills corridor, I'd like to see a skill. So we've seen a few in there. It's time to experiment. When you get to the end, choose left or right. Your challenge is to get the ball from here to there, there to there. Under control.
Oh, it's tough.
Juggle on the way back. Ready, play.
Yes.
So chance for you to have a breather. Lots of little touches, yeah? Lots of little touches, real quick. When you get here, one touch out your feet, then lots of little touches again. Lots of little touches. On your side of feet, turning round, and then you have your juggle, yes?
Okay.
If you're the goalkeeper, remember yesterday I said sometimes, through no fault of the volunteer coach, the goalkeeper doesn't get a chance to work on position-specific things. Guy or this lady might be an outfield coach, yes? So the goalkeeper, footwork in here. When you come to juggling, any little movements you've got with your hands, you can do to juggle the ball. Get the idea? Might be, if there's a spare ball or yours, you can do that. If you're an outfield player who wants to have a go at the juggling, just to experiment with your hands. Happy days. Ready? So, lots of touches, one touch. Lots of touches, one touch. Play when you're ready.
Good.
I like it. It was different in there. What was your record on the juggling? What's your best skill on the floor? Have a turn and a chat with one of your mates. Just share a bit of information about you. Does that make sense? Just how you might include the goalkeeper.
Actually,
this is a solo game. This is a chance to be individual. Yeah, a little moment of brilliance. Jordan Sancho ripping it up in Germany. Yeah, chance to be an English player. Yeah, or your favourite player from your country. Whatever you decide. I might be Andre Kanchelskis and go against the DNA for a change. So the race is this: when the first player breaks this line here, can you see it?
Yep.
second one can go. When the second one breaks this line, the third one can go and the fourth one. We're going to have a Formula One dribble relay. So the idea is, if you're at the front, we're going to go round twice, yeah? So you're going to do a circuit, you can choose left or right, it's up to you, but you must go round these cones. You're going to have a Formula One race. If you're at the front, your job is to stay in front. What about if you're second? What do you think the job is? Try and overtake. So if you just dribble out for me. Find this player, broke the line, I've got to try and get round him. What about if you're third?
Also
try and get round second or first without pushing. Yeah, no elbows, no pushing. If you are fourth, just try not to come last.
Yeah.
Yeah, don't come last. Yeah?
What do we do when we go back?
It's almost like we set that up. Right. Powerful coach now is going to say, calm to the back.
Yeah.
You ready? So as soon as they break this line, we go. How many times are we running?
Twice.
Last little tip. In here, try and take as many touches as you can. Keep the ball close whilst travelling fast. Remember that little tip. Head up, little touches. Ready? Quick. Go.
Oh, too late, Caroline.
Good work, catch him, mate. Twice round. Don't cut in corners.
Oh, boy.
Where's he going? Come back.
Who's first? Who's first? Oh, good. Stand in your order. The intensity goes up because it's a race, yes? What also starts to go down, though? Intensity goes up. What goes down, do you think?
Definitely.
Some of the quality. Now, not all of it. I'm not going to be that harsh. But here's where you need those tips of playing with your head up.
Observation.
Sometimes the ball runs away. We lose time. Yeah? So take a touch. Keep looking up. And remember those small touches, because you've got to keep it close. The other thing I watched was these two lines were all going that way. So where might the space be? To the left. So you can choose left or right. Right, whatever order you're standing in now, stand in the opposite order, reverse order. So if you're at the front, you go to the back. If you're second, you go third. Ready, play! Don't be last! Don't be last! Overtake him! Oh, good! Dribbling. So it's dribbling. What's the difference between dribbling and running with the ball? What's the difference? There's two techniques, dribbling, running with the ball. I'd ask my coaches this. What do you guys think?
Dribbling is with the ball.
Dribbling is with
the ball, most of the leg.
Ball close by. Yeah, because normally there's an opponent in your way. Now here, I haven't got defenders in because I want the young players to get comfortable on the ball before we go and do some 1v1 stuff. But here's where shortening my practice and also trying to get you to overtake means that you've got to keep the ball close to dribble around. Does that make sense? Also, a dribble, you should be able to start and stop quicker than if you're running with the ball. Yeah. I remember Gareth Bale scored a goal for Real Madrid in the Copa del Rey, and it took him three touches from the edge of his box to get the ball in the goal, because the ball was that far out in front of him and he was running really, really hard and fast. Whereas, who remembers a player called Ryan Giggs? Ryan Giggs, semi-final of the FA Cup against Villa Park, treble winning season, intercepted the ball, dribbled round four players. Your job, as they're dribbling across, is to find the gap and the space, try and get one complete pass. The record for doing it in about 30 seconds is 16 passes. If the ball hits one of them, you go back to zero. You get the idea? If you can't play forward, you can play sideways to come here. Move along the line like this. You guys can move along the line. Ready? On your marks, set, play! Oh, we're zipping those passes, good dribbling! Like the first touch out of the feet, well done!
How many rows? One.
Yeah, one through.
Yeah.
One, I call them killer questions. So if you had one question for me as a coach around that practice, what would it be? So just share with a friend, yeah, two things that you like around those outcomes and one killer question that you might want to ask, because you'll get a chance to put them to us this afternoon. Off you go, just 1 minute, 1 minute.